Hello computational thinking students, this is the tutorial for lecture 12. In lecture 12, the professors found out the longest sentence in the words data set. So how did they identify a sentence while going through the iterations? They went card by card until a card contained a full stop. A full stop indicates the end of a sentence. And the cards until that point, until that full stop, are taken to be one sentence. So that number of cards is supposed to be a sentence. So in order to identify the longest sentence, they first maintained a variable called longest sentence, which was initialized to zero. And additionally, they maintained another variable called count, which is also initialized to zero. And count was updated for every card in a sentence. When a sentence was finished, the longest sentence is compared against the count. And if count is greater than longest sentence was updated. And then for the next sentence, count is again reinitialized to zero. And card by card, we count the number of words in that sentence. As you can see, when count is now greater than longest sentence is updated to the current count value. In this way, at the end of iterating through the last card, we have the longest sentence value to be equal to the number of cards in the longest sentence in the data set. Now let's attempt to do a similar task in a different data set. Let's take, for example, the scorecard data set. Or you could even think about the shopping bill data set. And you notice that there is something fundamentally problematic with attempting this task on those data sets, because the words data set is a paragraph, which is a set of ordered words. Each sentence is an ordered sequence of words. And which is why when you go card after card, you know you are in the same sentence until you see a full stop. Whereas in the words data set or in the shopping bill data set, the cards are not ordered in any way. So pulling out a sequence from these cards doesn't make much sense. So in order to be able to execute a similar task in the other data sets, what we could do is, we could order them according to some property. For example, now, if you look at this particular ordering of the scorecard data set, I have clubbed the cards of the same birth month together. For example, this is April, this is August, this is December, 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 and then we move to Feb. So as you can see, these cards are arranged according to the month of birth. And so when you go card after card, you know you are in the same month until the month changes. So a very relevant task here would then be to find out what is the maximum number of students born in a particular month. So of all months, in one month, what is the maximum number of students born? So for this, like the professors, we first define a variable called max born in a month. And we initialize it to zero. And then we need another variable, which is the count variable, which also we initialize to zero. And this count we will keep incrementing for every card that we come across in a month. And whenever the month changes, we then update max in a month if it is lesser than the count. So we begin from the month of April. The count variable is initialized to zero and the max born in a month is also initialized to 0. The count variable is now incremented by 1 because we have found one card in April. And we go to the next card and the month changes, which means there's been only one card in the April month. And thus, the max born in a month variable needs to be updated to 1 because 0 is lesser than the 1 in count. Thus, we have the max born in a month now updated to 1, and count is now reinitialized to 0 for the month of August and incremented by 1 for the one card that we have seen. There's only one August card, therefore no update in max because max is already 1, and the count is now reinitialized to 0 because the month has changed and incremented by 1 for the month of December. Now that is 2 December, so count is 2. 3 December, so the count is 3. And 4 December, so the count is 4. And now the month is changed again, which means our max variable needs to be updated to 4 because 4 is greater than 1. And once that is done, the count is now reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of February. Count is 2 and the month has changed. There's no update in max because 4 is greater than 2. And now count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of January. Count is 2, 3, and the month changes. So no update in the max variable. Count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of July. That is 2 July cards, 3 July cards, and the month is changed. Again, no update in max. Count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of June. Only one June card. Count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented to 1 for the month of March. There's been no update in max because 4 is greater than 1. Now count is 2, count is 3, count is 4, and the month changes. So max doesn't have to be updated because it's already at 4 and 4 is equal to 4. So we now reinitialize count to 0 and increment it by 1 for the month of May. 2, 3, 4, and again month changes, which means max doesn't have to be updated. Count is reinitialized to 0, incremented by 1 for the month of November. This is 2 and November is done. So max is not updated and count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of October. There is 2 October cards and the month is changed again. Again, no update in max. Count is reinitialized to 0 and incremented by 1 for the month of September. 2 September, 3 September, and this is the last card. There is no card after this, which means we don't need to update max. Max has been at 4, and that is the maximum number of students born in a particular month. Thank you.